presentation on how he weathers his rolling stock.
I put my hat on the rain.
No, no.
Yeah, me too.
Remember when we see one of these?
One of
them. Ohio?
Yeah.
Take a picture of those going by?
Right.
Yeah, like she really remembers.
Yeah. Okay, pick them all, Sam. Okay, today's clinic is going to be out weathering. I'll talk about what I have here, what I use to get to the end product, as you can see right here. Some ways that I tried that didn't work, and some ways that did work. Something that's new is are these real deal weathering kits. I just got these during Springfield and tried them out. They work really well. This works really well with the Eclipse airbrush. Now a lot of people think, I think the idea is everyone wants to get the most expensive airbrush. I've learned the easy way that you don't need the very best. I use one right here, which is a $30 one from eBay, and I use it almost all the time. When you're weathering, this isn't what you need. When you're weathering, this is what you need. Now, as I was first trying to use an airbrush, the problems I had in the beginning was how dirty they get. It's awful sitting there cleaning the airbrush. I don't know about you guys, but that was the biggest problem I had. So it threw me off of weathering a lot. I was like, I'm not weathering. When these things get all gunked up, I was like, nah, I'll get this. But one thing I found out was, what happens with these is using the enamel paints will gunk these up almost in an instant. You'll spray and then they're gunked up and you want to change colors. Very hard to do, but when you weather it, the very good thing about these is we use acrylic paints from Walmart. They're about $2. And all this is just acrylic paint inside here. You mix it with water, and this is how I get my little mixtures up here, as you can see from the colors. One of the most colored paint I use is a fade mix. This is something I always have on me. It's the most important one. And the reason why is one coat of this is gonna take your plastic shiny brand new model, as you can see on these brand new plastic shiny, to this. This I did today just before I left. So what I basically do is I do everything by eye. I don't measure, so it's kind of hard.
So that's the color.
This is the color. This is the actual color. And as you can see here, I use this for the airbrush. As you can see, the consistency is just like milk. Put your finger in, somewhat to milk. You put more paint, it gets more milkier. You get less paint, it's more watery. Then you gotta do more coats. And what you're gonna have is the colors you use most. Nice light brown for the wheels, and a nice dark one, dark color for the top and the wheels as well. And a much lighter brown, which I use just the same as these ones along the bottom of the box cars and cover hoppers and trains and stuff. And just some other colors that I always just tap on, so they're already pre-mixed. Sometimes I have to mix up new colors to get the desired look that I'm looking for from a picture or whatever. Another thing that I use a lot is weathering powders. These are from AIM, they're about $5 or $6 a piece. There's probably 30 different colors. It's something I use quite often. They're called Galleria paint pens. Burnt Umber and Burnt Sienna. These ones I love. When I first started weathering project off, I always applied gloves, you know? I just have certain things. Fingerprints is the main reason. When I touch a brand new car coming out of the box, I have gloves and I take it out the box. There you go. Then the first thing I do is I apply a fade, whether it's gonna be faded a lot or a little, and I fade it down. And one of my favorite tools is a blow dryer. I love these. I just keep it in a holster, almost like sitting in front of me at the desk. When I'm sitting here, it's like this. So I spray it, pull it out, and it clicking. What I say about these, I use these so often, as you can see from right here.
Do you put something over the powder, or just much spray over the powder?
No, well, what I do is, like, after I apply the powder, there's Krylon Crystal Clear Flat. A lot of people use Delcoat, right? This is the equivalent of Delcoat. It just comes in a bigger 11 ounce as opposed to a 3 ounce. Lasts so much longer, costs so much less. I use it faithfully on everything that's here. I don't use Delcoat anymore. Not at $5 or $6 a can, you know? A lot of the reason why I use gloves is to come in handy for something like this. A project like this, what I will do is I always go like this. I only put a little bit because this, again, is acrylic paint and it dries pretty easy. And what I used to use, up until about a year ago, I used to always use foam brushes, you know, foam brushes. I used to take the bits and pieces of foam brushes, and that's how I applied the rust, because it gave it the texture. Anyway, so what I just recently started using, which I love, I recommend these. These are cosmetic applicator sponges in a woman's eye. They make a mild. And these are great because, as you see, it's a very sponge-like material. I cut a piece off and break it off, you know, whatever way it goes. And then I go like this. And I usually do a lot of this all the time. And then, as you can see, like on here, if I wasn't trying to be really, you know, specific, I could use this blobbing one right here and just kind of go across the bottom. And then across the top. And then, you know, you get this, you want to put it down lightly. You don't want to make it too thick, but you want to put it in there. And I can leave it just like that. And usually, I'll just instantly dry it. You know, and what's best about this is, you get a rusted look right there. But how you enhance this is you use your powders. And like I said, I have a whole bunch of mixtures of colors. But for example, after this dries, I'll show you what the look is like when you add a rust color like this. This one I actually just did today, as you can see the top here. That was done the same way I just showed you, dabbing it with the applicator, and then going across the top in a little bit of areas. And then once it was dried, I added powders to it, and the powders gave it that good effect. But you can see it's not just one round, you can see a little bit of red into it and stuff. And on top, this one done with the powders and the dabbing, and then this one right here, you can see those words done at all. So this down was weathered, and this up was it. And I use this, again, with no airbrush. So you can come off with any effect, even without an airbrush. Trucks, I just take off, I grab the sponge like this, and I hold the truck there just like this, and I'll just right over the truck. And once that's done, I'll drag it quick, then I add powder to it, and it gives you a really nice, it gives it like the textured look, you know, textured rust. Like it's not just painted on, you actually can see it. So if I'm not gonna follow from a picture, I follow the guidance here of what I wanna do. And as you can see, fading the paint, number one. So I look at this and decide, what's it gonna be? Am I going to a logo or letter fade, which is another part of the technique. If you just wanna fade your lettering and stuff, I use a fine grit piece of sandpaper, and I'll just, you know, sand down the logo alone, and then I'll get that effect of faded logo. Repatching. This one was done from a picture, because you can see it was repatched to SRN, and it was previously Marionette Terminal Hook, something like that. But I patched it over to the picture, and that's how I did that one. So that's an option you can add to it. Yellow safety stripes. I really got into yellow safety stripes a lot for the newer equipment. And the reason is, you see a lot that goes by and you have the patch, they have the yellow stripes, just like on these. So you'll see these quite often. And what I use is I use 3M reflective tape, which gives it a real reflection graffiti. Obviously with modern stuff, graffiti's big. As you can see on this engine here, I did this from a picture. This was done with graffiti on it. And this as well. This was done from a picture. And the graffiti looked really cool, so that's why I wanted to do this one. I'm actually doing a second one right now for a customer. And I just really like that one. I thought it was cool. I have invested quite a bit of money into pink pens from Michael's and still one. The name of the other place. But I've invested a lot. I use these micro art ones a lot. And they come in so many different sizes. 005, 03, and they're just really, really tiny. Rust spots, which is obviously a big one. As you can see on top of a lot of things, just a rust spot, you know, just like it was painted on top and turned rusty. So, pretty easy to do, you know, just a very light weathering and put that on top and it stands out, looks really nice. Another thing is dirt, grime, and sand. So that's what you just see, the normal dirtiness on them. And I always do my couplers, my trucks, and the wheels. My biggest thing is I don't like, you know, when you see something that's really, really nicely weathered and something like this, I did part of the side, but even if it's weathered and then it looks all nicely weathered and then the trucks are just shiny and the wheels are shiny in the side, I don't like that. That's really like a big throwing off, and also the coupler too. And then scratches, scuffs, and gouges, that's pretty simple to do. I just use an X-Acto blade and I scratched. Another technique that I actually just came up with probably about a year and a half ago, which is, It's really caught on, but I don't use it much because I like to do specific weathering. I think this one way that I started that I came up with that works really good. It's good for somebody who just wants to like color an egg. You know, you dip an egg and send it out to egg. And the next one, well, that's one I call weather dipping, which I just did it one day. I put this whole glass, started squeezing in all this acrylic paint, and it was like a mixture of mud. And what I always did first is, because you can't take just a brand new boxcar gondola or whatever, you can't just take it out and dip it in the feed mix, and you do that all over the whole thing, and then once you weather dip it, gravity takes over and it goes everywhere. It doesn't just pull in all the sections, all the areas where it's pulled at looks awful. So I always do the fade mix and then dip them. And what I mean by dipping them is, I literally set up the sink. I have a big cup and I go like this. And then it starts, you know, just dripping it off. I tip this side, I leave everything on. And then I take it and I put it like on top of the cup and it's still dripping down. And I'm like, clip this. And then I let it sit there. Then I sit here with this and I'll blow dry it until it's all dry. That's kind of the best effect. And once you have it all dried up, you can look at it and say, wow, it's great, and send it on its way. Or if you want it dirty, you just dip it again and then blow dry it, and then you have this really, really nice model. Technique that I think I started too, just because I try anything, I don't care. I've destroyed many locomotives and stuff like that. Bulging out the sides of gondolas, right? You know, like that. I tried everything. I tried using a lighter, set them on fire. I tried using the soldering iron, but it burns, you know, same thing. And I was like, what's that smell? I found that the really best thing is a butane lighter. Burns, you know, nice and bright and hot, fast. And I just put it in very quickly, and it turns into like a plastic bag, and you can take your finger and push it out. I don't recommend it because it's hot. So I just basically take a back of a brush, and I just push it out. And you only have a couple seconds, and it gets hard. And then it's already done, it stays there. Gives you a bulging effect, the most realistic bulging effect you can get. I've seen people actually, before I started doing this technique about 2 years ago, they would actually put some type of epoxy on the outside, let it dry, then paint it. So it was like they were building it, basically. I actually make them so that you could